Perhaps one of the most stunning pieces of architecture on the planet. Designed to capture the lavishness of Earth, fresh air, crystal blue waters, it is the only resort in St. Lucia with iconic views of the Pedee and Gros Piton Mountains. The rooms at this hotel are tech-free. There's no phone, no television, forcing you to unwind and be at one with nature. This year, Travel and Leisure named Jade Mountain the top resort in the Caribbean, Bermuda, and the Bahamas. And I sat down with Jade Mountain co-owner and executive director, Carolyn Trubetskoy. Welcome, Carolyn.
Hi, nice to be here.
So you and your husband are really the ultimate entrepreneurs. You took a huge risk early on. Tell me about that.
Well, I think we're not only entrepreneurs, but probably pioneers, having discovered a spot in the Caribbean over 30 years ago when Nick, my husband, found a little place called Anne-Chastenay in Sufra, St. Lucia. And without having any knowledge of how a hotel should be run, decided to become a hotelier after having, in fact, been an architect for all his previous years.
I think this is a dream, actually, of a lot of people. They visit a beautiful place and they see it and they think, what if I just gave up that life, the one that I live every day, and I move to paradise and I start a hotel?
Absolutely. I think for those that actually have taken that step, you never really plan it. It's sort of fate finds you. I think when Nick came to St. Lucia in the early 70s, he did not expect that he would stay in St. Lucia. But the island is just so amazing, the landscape, and I mean, there's almost something spiritual when you see our lovely Piton Mountains, and it really hooked him forever. And he decided to invest with two partners at that point in the small hotel Anne-Chastenay, and made it into a world-renowned hotel in a few years.
And then used his architecture background to build out Jade Mountain.
Indeed, yeah. That happened a bit later. We opened Jade Mountain in the ending of 2006. And with Jade Mountain, Nick had reached a stage in his life where he really wanted to give St. Lucia not only a new hotel, but almost like a landmark. And since that landmark is facing our Piton Mountains, that landmark had to really be good.
It had to be as beautiful as the mountains. Absolutely. And as special and exotic.
The Pitons and Jade Mountain had to deserve each other. So when you're at Jade Mountain, everything is about the amazing view of our Pitons, and it was built in celebration of that view. And wherever you go there, you see the Pitons.
Your hotel and resort has been named the top hotel and resort in the entire Caribbean, including the Bahamas. What is the reason for that? What are some of the great things about what you have to offer?
It is, in my opinion, that magical combination of an amazing location, great architecture, an amazing suite where you just don't want to ever step out again. You want to be in your suite, admire the view, be one and one with our Pitons. And of course, last but not least, the great resort team there that really makes every guest feel extra special. I think that is a great part of it as well.
And you also do something that I'm sure a lot of people would appreciate. You keep it pretty much tech-free.
We keep the resort tech-free, absolutely. I must admit, Wi-Fi slipped in, and cell phones do work if that guest really insists to have cell phones, but it is, we would like our guests to consider to really not play with all these gadgets and just be unplugged, truly unplugged, and enjoy what is in front of them, which is an amazing view that makes you perhaps rethink what your, you know, purpose in life should be.
Rethink your reality.
Absolutely.
And tell the boss that you're somewhere where you don't get cell phone reception.
Indeed, I'm sure it can happen.
So you are now offering, is it scuba diving?
Yes, that's part of Anne-Chastenay, our Jade Mountain sister property, and we have offered scuba diving since the early 80s. We actually, in a way, brought scuba diving to the island of St. Lucia. It was not known then that the island was so fortunate in having fantastic coral reefs, and so we started a small diving operation and have offered diving ever since.
When it comes to choosing a location in paradise, I think for a lot of people, they see the pictures on the internet, they look beautiful, but people are always skeptical because sometimes you show up and it doesn't look the way that it looks in the pictures. What's your number one piece of advice to people who are booking vacations over the internet?
It's an interesting question. I mean, for us, I'm always happy when a client says to us, you know, you gave us more than we expected. The pictures do not do it justice, which is a lot to say when you see our pictures, they're not ugly.
Yes, and I've been there and I've seen it and the pictures are beautiful, but yeah. It's very different to be looking out on the pitons.
You know, I mean, there are so many sites now that offer candid photos. Maybe it's a good thing to check them out, because a truly beautiful place looks beautiful even when candid shots are taken.
Right, so go to those websites like TripAdvisor, Yelp, that kind of thing.
Yeah.
How has that changed your business, knowing that there is an online world of online reviews and anybody can come and say anything?
You know, it's a challenge for hotels, I think, because sometimes we feel perhaps put on the spot in not always a fair way, right? But on the other side, if you do run a professional hotel, and if you strive every day to give your guests the best possible customer experience, then clearly you have this under control.
And your number one piece of advice to people who are looking to book vacations, honeymoons in paradise, when's the best time of year to book?
The Caribbean, in my opinion, is a place that you can visit year-round. I feel that the bad rap we sometimes get about hurricanes in the summer season doesn't really exist for us that live in the Caribbean. I was actually thinking this morning that New York seemed to have been as exposed as the Caribbean. So you don't say to the visitors that come to New York, stay away from New York in the summer season, and I would give the same advice to travelers for the Caribbean. It's a great place for the whole year. We don't have dramatically changing temperatures. Generally, of course, the winter season is the high demand season because it's cold everywhere else. But come anytime.
Come, you're always
absolutely
welcome.
Absolutely, yeah.
And how do you get the best deal?
You know, nowadays it makes sense to look around on the internet, but there's also nothing wrong in just writing to the hotel and ask them directly what's the best deal you can offer for this period. And usually we would in fact tell such a person what is available.
Thank you so much for joining us on Real Biz. Really fun
talk. It was a pleasure. Thank you.